So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams, whether it is central government exam or any state government exam. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me here. And here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the Krishi Udan 2.0. The question is, consider the following statements with respect to Krishi Udan 2.0 and you have to identify the correct statements. All right. So let's discuss about this scheme, this new initiative of the Ministry of Civil Aviation. So guys, remember, the Ministry of Civil Aviation and the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, they both together have launched this particular mission, this particular scheme, which is known as Krishi Udan 2.0. Now, as the name suggests, that this scheme is converging the two sectors, aviation and agriculture. And the basic objective of this particular scheme, this particular initiative, is to facilitate the movement of agricultural produce with the help of air transportation ki help se agricultural produce ka movement is the basic objective of this scheme. And of course, this will benefit both the sectors, agriculture ko bhi benefit karega and aviation ko bhi benefit karega. Okay, so this is the basic objective of this scheme. And if someone asks you which ministry is the nodal ministry, the answer would be Ministry of Civil Aviation is the nodal agency to implement this particular scheme. And of course, who is the Minister of Civil Aviation? It's Jyotiraditya Sindhya. Now let's talk about some key facts from this particular initiative. So number one is the movement of agri produced by air transportation. Under this, there are some waiver of charges. Like for example, full waiver of landing and parking charges for aircrafts. Any aircraft which is carrying the agricultural produce under this scheme, उसके ऊपर कोई भी लैंडिंग और पार्किंग चार्जेस नहीं होगी. देयर विल बी नो लैंडिंग एंड पार्किंग चार्ज ऑन एनी एयरक्राफ्ट व्हिच इज कैरिंग द एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोड्यूस अंडर दिस स्कीम. आल्सो टर्मिनल नेविगेशन लैंडिंग चार्जेस, द चार्जेस व्हिच इज लिवाइड फॉर नेविगेशन ऑन द टर्मिनल, एंड आल्सो द रूट नेविगेशन फैसिलिटी चार्जेस, द चार्जेस व्हिच आर लिवाइड फॉर नेविगेशन ऑफ रूट्स, दीज चार्जेस विल आल्सो बी वेव्ड ऑफ फॉर इंडियन फ्रेटर्स के लिए ये चार्जेस वेव हो जाएंगे. एंड डेफिनेटली इट विल रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, एंड डेफिनेटली इट विल रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोड्यूस. जब वो मार्केट में जाएगा तो उसका कॉस्ट क्या होगा, कम होगा. नंबर टू इज कार्गो रिलेटेड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर विल बी स्ट्रेंथेंड. कार्गो रिलेटेड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर विल बी स्ट्रेंथेंड बाय क्रिएटिंग एयर साइड ट्रांजिट एंड ट्रांसशिपमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. दे विल क्रिएट airside transit and transshipment infrastructure. Now, what is this airside transit infrastructure? See, let's say this is a cargo. This is a cargo, and this cargo is in a flight taking off from the Mumbai airport. So, it is coming to Delhi. Okay, this cargo is coming to Delhi, and from here, this cargo has to be exported to it has to be exported to Dubai. Now, when it will land to Delhi, there must be some kind of infrastructure where this cargo is put. एक कोई ऐसा infrastructure होना चाहिए जहाँ पे इस cargo को रखा जाएगा. And same day अगर वो Dubai की दूसरी flight में रखना है उसको, तो of course कहीं ना कहीं तो उसको रखना पड़ेगा. Then it will be reloaded to the flight going to Dubai. Alright, so this type of infrastructure for holding this cargo at this Delhi airport is known as what? Airside transit. Now, what is this transshipment infrastructure? This is somewhat related to airside transit only. Transshipment infrastructure kya hota hai? When one cargo is moved from one vessel to another. When it is moving from one vessel to another, then this, obviously in vessels ko rakhne ke liye bhi to koi jagah chahiye. There is a need of the space for putting these vessels where the cargo is transmitting from one to another. Theek hai, jab cargo ek se dusre mein ja raha hai, तो इन वेसल्स को रखने के लिए भी तो जगह चाहिए. ऑलराइट, एंड दैट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज व्हाट? ट्रांसशिपमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. सो दीज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर विल बी डेवलप्ड अंडर दिस स्कीम. कंसेशंस आर बीइंग सॉर्ट फ्रॉम द अदर बॉडीज लाइक द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. सो द मिनिस्ट्री इज आस्किंग स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स टू रिड्यूस द सेल्स टैक्स टू 1% ऑन एयरलाइन टर्मिनल फी. Now, what is this airline terminal fee? This is basically charge for holding the cargo. Okay, this fees, this charge is being levied for holding the cargoes. Cargoes ko hold karne ka jo paisa hota hai, that is known as airline terminal fee. And the Ministry of Civil Aviation has asked the states to reduce it to reduce the sales tax to 1% on airline terminal fee. Then, a new platform eKushal will be developed. एक नया प्लेटफॉर्म ई कुशल बनाया जाएगा एंड ई कुशल स्टैंड्स फॉर ई स्टैंड्स फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कुशल स्टैंड्स फॉर कृषि उड़ान फॉर सस्टेनेबल होलिस्टिक एग्री लॉजिस्टिक दिस इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ई कुशल नाउ व्हाट दिस प्लेटफॉर्म विल डू दिस प्लेटफॉर्म रिमेंबर विल प्रोवाइड ऑल द रिलेटेड इंफॉर्मेशन टू ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स ऑफ दिस स्कीम एंड अदर देन दिस इट विल ऑल्सो कोऑर्डिनेट मॉनिटर एंड इवेल्युएट द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस स्कीम इस स्कीम को कोऑर्डिनेशन करने का मॉनिटरिंग करने का इवैल्यूएशन करने का काम किसका होगा ऑफ दिस प्लेटफॉर्म ई कुशल एंड इन फ्यूचर इन कमिंग मंथ्स दिस ई कुशल विल बी कन्वर्ज्ड विद ई नैम विच इज नथिंग बट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक नेशनल एग्रीकल्चरल मार्केट ऑलराइट एंड रिमेंबर अभी के लिए फॉर द फेज वन टोटल 53 एयरपोर्ट्स हैव बीन सिलेक्टेड for implementing this scheme and these airports will not only provide access to regional domestic market but they will also provide access to the international markets theek hai to international jo export hai usme bhi madad hogi and the scheme is applicable starting from this financial year to the financial year 2025 all right and there are these seven major keh lo ya abhi tak saat routes pe hi focus hai these are the seven routes on which the focus is there in the phase 1 number 1 is amritsar dubai for the product baby corn darbhanga to rest of india lychees because lychees are very famous from darbhanga and we have a shahi lychee which has a gi tag from bihar sikkim to the rest of india organic produce of course sikkim is the first organic state of the country chennai vizag kolkata to far east seafoods because all these are the स्टेट्स वेयर जहाँ जो कि सी के साथ बाउंड्री करते हैं अगरतला दिल्ली एंड दुबई पाइनएप्पल डिब्रूगढ़ दिल्ली एंड दुबई मैंडरिन एंड ऑरेंजेस एंड गुवाहाटी टू हांगकॉन्ग पल्सेस फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स सो ये भी आपको याद रखना पड़ेगा बिकॉज ज़्यादा नहीं है ओनली 7 आर देयर और इनके कौन कौन से प्रोडक्ट्स इनमें यूज होंगे ये भी आपको याद रखना पड़ेगा यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस टेबल दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट So this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statements out of these four. The scheme will facilitate the movement of agri produce by air transportation. Of course, this is the basic objective. Yes, sahi hai. There are seven focus routes and products. This is also correct. Total 100 airports have been selected under the scheme. Is that so? Kya 100 airports hai? No. Total 53 airports have been selected. And it will be implemented till the financial year 2030. No, it will be implemented till the financial year 2025. So only 1 and 2 statements are correct. Therefore, guys, the correct answer will be what option E? Only 1 and 2. Only 1 and 2 is the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. Now, these questions, guys, are very simple. And these can be asked in your one marker. These are basically, isme zyada hame detail mein nahi padhna hai. And maine pehle bhi bataya tha in such type of questions you just have to I'm talking about question number 3 I'm talking about question number 3 which is with respect to the loans theek hai from Asian Development Bank se loan liya hai so is type ke question mein you just have to remember 2-3 things from which bank the loan has been taken for which state the loan has been taken and what is the objective of the loan that is it isse zyada padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hoti but before that we have a question number 2 Which country along with AIIB, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, has organized the 6th meeting of Board of Governors of AIIB with the theme Investing Today and Transforming Tomorrow. In this particular 6th meeting of Board of Governors of AIIB, there will not be any question that will be asked in your exam. Koi bhi aisa question nahi hoga. They can ask only this question and isse zyada, they can ask the theme also. That's it. Iske alawa, other than this, they are not going to ask any question from this particular meeting because in such meetings what happens is that the board of governors meet and they discuss certain topics and from those discussions the questions cannot be asked all right so with which country this country guys is UAE government of UAE along with AIIB has organized this 6th annual meeting of board of governors of AIIB And from India side, our Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman participated. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman participated from India side. Talking about UAE, so UAE's first female astronaut, what is the name? Noura Al-Matroshi. Noura Al-Matroshi is the first female astronaut from UAE. Also in the year 2022, UAE is sending a lunar rover which is known as Rashid. And there is a Mars mission of UAE which is known as what? Hope Probe, or you can say Al-Amal. And of course Abu Dhabi is the capital. Question number 3. For which state government of India has signed a loan agreement with ADB worth $4.5 million to support project preparation and design activities to improve the urban mobility? See, so you have to remember 2-3 things. As I told you, number 1, the bank. Number 2, the amount. Number 3, the objective, which is for improving the urban mobility. And number 4, the state. Kiske liye ye diya gaya hai? Theek hai? So this loan of $4.5 million has been given to the government of Mizoram. And for what? For urban mobility. That is it. Option A is the correct answer. Mizoram's capital is Aizawl. And who is the CM of Mizoram? Zoranthanga is the chief minister. There is a very famous festival in Mizoram which is known as Chapcharkut, and a very similar festival which is known as Mimkut. Chapcharkut and Mimkut are the famous festivals of Mizoram. You will find Murlen National Park in Mizoram, and also the very famous Dampa Tiger Reserve. Okay. Moving ahead to question number 4. With which international bank government of India has signed a loan agreement to promote agribusiness network to boost farm incomes and reduce food losses in Maharashtra? Kaun se? Now here, this question is again based on the loan. So again, you just have to remember 2-3 things. State, objective, bank. Theek hai, bas ye teen, and the amount, of course. This is the $100 million loan, I believe. Yes, this is the $100 million loan. Theek hai, ye yaad rakhna, this is the $100 million loan. So this bank, guys, is once again ADB, Asian Development Bank. Asian Development Bank chairperson is Masatsugu Asakawa. AIIB, Jin Lincoln. AIIB, World Bank, David Malpass. And then we have New Development Bank, Marcus Prado Troijo of Brazil. And European Central Bank, Christine Lagarde. These are the chairperson of these international banks. And the correct answer is what? Option C, ADB. And remember that this loan will be given under the Magnet Project of Maharashtra Government. Okay. So option C is the correct answer. Question number 5. So in the last class, we have discussed this Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Scheme. And at that time, I told you that if they will come with some additional information, I will cover that. So rest of the things we have already covered. The new additional information is the total outlay. And this total outlay was also announced in the Union Budget 2021-22. So the question is, what is the total outlay of Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat Yojana, Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission? So it is 64,180 crores. Option A is the correct answer to this question. Other than this, there is no additional information which is provided. That information we will get when the detailed guidelines will be launched. And also remember, Swachh Bharat Mission Urban 2.0 jo humne padha tha, and Amrut Mission 2.0 jo humne padha tha, uske liye detailed guidelines launch hogi hai, and these schemes I will cover in a separate session of the government scheme. Theek hai, kyunki jo detailed guidelines hongi usko padhne mein time lagega, and that government scheme ka wo jo session hoga, that will be separately conducted for both the schemes, Swachh Bharat Mission Urban 2.0 and Amrut Mission 2.0. And also remember, Amrut Mission 2.0 mein they have again changed the indicative outlay. It is now 2,99,000 crore. So ye chauthi baar hai jab ye outlay change ho raha hai. Ek baar 2,87 tha, fir 77 tha, fir 297 tha. Now they are saying 299,000 crores. So, jo bhi official document mein hoga, I will read that and will come up with a separate session. Question number 6. Which state department of animal husbandry and dairying has organized an awareness program and entrepreneurship schemes of the department? Very, very easy question. Or remember, this awareness program This awareness program was conducted in 8 UTs. All the 8 UTs, currently there are 8 UTs in the country. And one state which is Goa. Okay? It has been conducted in 8 UTs and Goa. And now what is this basically awareness, entrepreneurship awareness program? Hai kya ye? This is creating awareness among the youth, among the citizens regarding the entrepreneurship components of two schemes, which are National Livelihood, National Livestock Mission and Rashtriya Gokul Mission. There are certain entrepreneurship components under these two particular missions, National Livestock Mission and Rashtriya Gokul Mission. So, un entrepreneurship component ke baare mein awareness create karne ke liye, this program was conducted by Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying in 8 UTs and one state, which is Goa. So, the correct answer will be what? Goa. Who is the Minister of Animal Husbandry and Dairy? It's Mr. Purushottam Rupala. Purushottam Rupala is the Minister of Animal Husbandry, Dairying and Farming. And in Goa, you will find very famous GI tags, like we have Khola Chili, we have Harmal Chili, and then also we have Moira Banana. Then we have a sweet dish which is known as Khaje. And Goa Chief Minister, of course, is Mr. Pramod Sawant. Question number 7, which is the last question for today. Name the National Awareness Program that has been launched by Minister of MSME, Narayan Rane. Narayan Rane is the Minister of MSME for promoting entrepreneurship among youth. So, इसमें भी ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. This is again an National Awareness Program for promoting what? For promoting entrepreneurship among the youth. That is it. Just remember the name of the program, the objective of the program and which ministry launched it. So, it has been launched by Ministry of MSME, headed by Mr. Narayan Rane, and the name of the program, guys, is what? Sambhav. Option B. Sambhav is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. So, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comments section. I'll see you on Monday with the brand new session. Thank you so much. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.